In this Revolut tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up and use Revolut step by step. With my personal experience of using Revolut for over 3 years, I'll walk you through the sign up process and show you how to make international transfers with the lowest possible fees. So even if you're new to Revolut or making international transfers, I guarantee that you'll feel like an expert by the end of this video. Now, the first step in signing up is to click on this link in the description below or type this into your browser, where you will be able to get a special deal on Revolut. You'll receive 3 months on their premium plan for free, which will allow you to save on extra fee-free transactions and cash withdrawal fees. So if you want to save a fair bit of money, then I recommend you check out this link. So now type in your phone number and click on Get Started. And now you receive a text message on your phone to go and download the app and use it from there. Revolut is mainly a mobile app. Revolut's desktop app is pretty bland and there's not many features for you to use. Everything is done based on the phone. So I'll take you there now. So from the text message that you received from Revolut, click on the link they provided. This will take you to either the Apple Store or Google Play Store where you can install the app. Now once that's done, click on Open. And now you should be taken to your dashboard, which looks something like this. Now the next step, I'm going to show you how to add money to your Revolut account. So you would simply go to your dashboard and click on Add Money. And there are a few ways to add money to your account. You can either link a credit or debit card here by clicking on Add Card Securely, enter in your card details, and it'll be added as a method of topping up money to your account. And there are other ways like using a bank transfer, which I recommend as it'll have the lowest fees, or Google Pay for Android and Apple Pay for Apple users. So we'll pick the regular bank transfer for this example. Then you can see here, if I'm receiving Australian dollar locally, then I would type in these details, the money is received. But if I'm sending it from overseas, then you would go Swift and put these details in. And once your money has arrived into your account, it'll simply show up on your dashboard here. Now that you have money in your account, I'm going to show you how to exchange currency in Revolut. So you click on Exchange, and now you would choose the currency you're exchanging from and to. So in this case, I'll choose US dollar. And for this example, I'll just do one Australian dollar, and it shows the rate up here. And if you click into it, it can show you the rate that it has been previously in the last 1 month up to a maximum of around 15 years. Now, if you like this pair, then you can always star it to add to your watch list. Or if you're not happy with this rate, then you can always change from a market order to a stop order or a limit order and set a price that you're willing to exchange when it hits a certain value. But for simplicity's sake, if you're just traveling and want to make some quick conversions, then you would just convert it this way and click on Review Order once you're happy with the amount and the rate. Double check everything, and you can see here the fees is zero, as long as I stay under the limit of my plan. And if you're happy with that, click on Sell AUD to USD, and there it is. And now you can see my Australian dollar has reduced by $1 from 25 to 24. But if you want to see where it's gone, then you can click on Accounts. And if I click on US dollar, you can see the amount has been converted. And if you click on All Main, then you can see the full amount in their account. Now, a couple of important things to note when making currency exchange is that you have a limit. The limit will be $2,000 on the standard plan, $20,000 on the premium plan, which you'll get for free for 3 months by using the link in the previous step, or unlimited amount on the metal plan. So make sure to check that before you make the transfer. If you're using it for a daily account, then no worries, stick to the free plan. But if you're making some big transfers, it will save you a lot of money to sign up to the right plan before making this transfer, even if it's only for 1 month. And the other very important thing is to make sure you only exchange currencies and send money on weekdays, because Revolut will charge you an extra 1-2% transfer fee if you transfer on a weekend. So only Monday to Friday if you can help it. But if you're desperate on the weekend, then try and do as minimal as you can. That's just a tip for you. I would like to now show you how to add foreign currency accounts to your Revolut account. We can do that by clicking on Accounts and click on Add New. And now you would choose Currency Account here at the top. And you can see all the different currencies that Revolut allow you to add to your account. For this example, I'll pick the British Pound. It's as easy as that. And if you want to change back to your previous account, you just click on Accounts and select the one that you want to choose. Now to see the bank account details for that particular account, you would come here to More and click on Details. And this will be the details that you want to send to someone if you want them to send British Pounds to you. But you can see here, the bank details is not a local bank. It's still in Australia. Now the next part, which I believe is the most important part, is to send money internationally with Revolut. And to do that, you would click on Payments. Then you have two options. The first is to click on the calendar, which allows you to schedule a payment. You would do this once again, if it was a weekend and you don't want to get charged fees, then you would simply set the date to a weekday and in a few days time, it would do the transaction automatically for you. Then you just click on this plus button here and now the new transfer page will come up where you have different options of sending money. You can send it to your Revolut friend if they're on Revolut and this is totally free of charge and the options will be using their Rev tag, which I showed you at the beginning, or adding their phone or email, or scanning their QR code that they provide you. You can also send money to someone's bank account by putting in their bank details here. If it's a person, then use this box. If it's a business, then you would click here and type in their business name and account details. You can also send to a group. If you want to receive money or send to someone, but you don't know all their account details, then you can click on Create a Payment Link, choose your option, choose your amount, click Send, and a link will be created for them to receive this money. This is a very handy feature. Now the way that I normally do it, and the way that I suggest most people do it, is to click here to send internationally. Pick your currency destination. For this example, I'll use USD. Choose your account that you want to send from. Select the amount. And this next step is where you choose the method. In the recipient's details section, you would click on the ACH and it'll offer you different methods, either wire transfer, ACH, or SWIFT code. Now choose your preference, but in general, I use ACH because it's got the lowest fees. Type in their account details. Click add recipient again, and there it is. And now you would review their name, account details, and the exchange rate you're going to receive, along with the fees. And if or once you're happy with that, then you would simply click send. And that's it. It's really straightforward, and it's a lot cheaper than sending from your traditional bank account. For example, if you're sending money overseas, you're going to be charged immediately a wire transfer fee of at least $10 to $30. Whereas here, the fees are in the cents. So this is a really good way of making use of your Revolut account. Even though you're now an expert at transferring money internationally with Revolut, there's still a few more important features and benefits like this debit card here. So I recommend you check out this more in-depth tutorial here where I go through every important features of Revolut. And I'll see you in that next tutorial.